Is it really worth to buy a term life insurance? A term insurance is a life insurance that offers coverage for a limited number of years. It pays out a death benefit to a nominee if the policyholder dies during the term of the policy. There is no survival benefit or cash value of a term policy. For the same premium, a term life insurance plan offers much higher coverage than a whole life insurance plan. The reason is simple. You may actually survive a term plan and the insurer may not have to pay out. Whether you should buy a term plan or not, depends on your circumstances. Ask yourself this: what would happen to your family if something happens to you? If you have purchased a term life insurance, it would provide either a lump sum amount or a regular income or a combination thereof, to your nominee. This would allow your family to sustain the same lifestyle without compromising on their dreams. While they would miss you and have to deal with the emotional turmoil, the insurance would ensure they don't have to worry about the finances immediately. In other words, if you have people who depend on you for their expenses, or if you have outstanding liabilities which will have to be honored by your family members in case of your demise, you should get a term life insurance. If you do not have any dependents and don't have any liabilities, like a loan, you do not need a term life insurance. Remember that liabilities does not just mean liabilities that you have right now, but also future liabilities. For example, if you are married and have a child, the child's education is not something that you have to pay right now, but the child would depend on you for these when he reaches the right age. Even if your spouse is earning and dependent on you for her livelihood, it is your responsibility to ensure that your family's standard of living does not suffer in case something goes wrong. A term life insurance comes in handy in such scenarios. In short, term life insurance is undoubtedly the most cost-effective and most efficient way to protect for a loss during a specific period of time. More often than not, the owners of these policies have nothing to show for all the premiums paid during the policy term period. The trade-off is the cheap cost and high overall benefit derived from these policies. For example, I purchased a $2 million 20 term life policy when I was 40 years old. The policy costs me $1,700 per year and I will end up paying $34,000 over the life of this policy. I had also had an agent quote me a whole life policy, and for this plan, I was quoted a premium of $3,100 for a $2 million whole life policy. The most significant difference between this policy and the term policy is that the whole life policy will always pay a death benefit and will never terminate. The reason for this is due to the fact that you pay premiums that go into two buckets with whole life. One bucket pays for the $2 million death benefit and the other goes into the cash value of the whole life policy. For this reason, the whole life policy will cost you more than a term policy. I decided that instead of having the insurance company invest the cash value bucket for me, I would buy term life and invest my own money in my own investment vehicle and avoid the expenses that the insurance companies charge on a whole life policy. This is a very important distinction between term and whole life. Instead of having an insurance company invest the cash value bucket in investments that are not tailored to my specific investment objective, I would make investment decisions that would be in keeping with my own investment needs. Term life allowed me to protect myself for a specific term of time at an affordable price, and with the money I was not paying on a whole life policy, I would invest in low-expense investment choices that were more specific to my financial needs. The only downside to term life is the potential exposure at the end of the term. However, presumably at the end of the term, you no longer have the risk you had at the time you purchased the term life policy. For example, when I purchased my $2 million term life policy, I was 40, and when it expires, I will be 60. At that time, all my children will have graduated from college, and therefore the need for the policy and my mortality risk to my wife will be considerably less, which is why I purchased the policy in the first place. I would encourage term life for anyone that is looking for a low-cost, high-value policy of protection. I would argue that most of us would do better by investing in low-cost index funds with the money that would alternatively gone to the insurance company's whole life cash value bucket, without investment direction and with higher overall expenses.